Deep in the western ghats of Karnataka lies a place hidden away from all the tourist maps, which holds secrets yet to be discovered. And the adventurer in me, who thrives on the rush of discovery, had to come explore the unexplored. Let me show you the true untouched gem of Karnataka, Yellapur.
Yo, what's up guys? I hope you guys are having a great day because I know I am. Today we are heading out for a day trip to explore a small town in the Western Ghats called as Yellapur. It is very close to my place. It's only 80 kilometers from Karwar and there are many waterfalls and viewpoints over there. So it's gonna be a very long day. We were supposed to leave around at 6 in the morning, but it's already 8 now. And by we, I mean I have a friend with me, Jayesh, who is not at all interested to be in this video, so we'll not force him. But he's gonna help me shoot the content. And the weather is really good. It's very moody and cloudy, perfect for a day exploration. So we'll not waste any more time. Let's hit the road.
Bengaluru to Yellapur is around 422 kilometers. And if you're already in Gokarna, it's about 80 kilometers, which will roughly take you around 2 hours. From Gokarna, it is advised to leave early morning because you have to cross Devmane Ghat, which has a lot of hairpin bends. And if you get stuck behind the chain of trucks, then it will take you forever to reach your destination.
I guess we have reached Yellapur town, but we're not gonna stop here. We're gonna head straight to our first location, that's Satodi Waterfall. I've heard that it's completely off-road, so it's gonna take us time and we are already late. So let's head straight to the falls.
Satodi Falls is 25 kilometers from Yellapur, and once you take the diversion from the town, the road gets really ugly. The last 10 kilometers is complete off-road, and it gets only worse during the peak monsoons. So the best time to visit this waterfall is between October to December, considering the road and also the flow of the waterfall.
Right now, we have come across a spot where there are two roads. One goes towards Hanging Bridge and one goes towards Satodi Falls. First, we're gonna explore Satodi Falls and then we're gonna come back and head towards this bridge. Let's go. So guys, so finally after 4 hours, we have reached to the starting point of the Satodi Falls. Actually, it's gonna take you around 3 hours from Karwar, but we stopped for a while. We were taking few drone shots as well, so 1 hour extra. From the checkpost, it's just 5 to 10 minutes walk, and he charged us 70 rupees for the parking and 20 rupees each. So since we are two people, it's 40 and 70, so it's in total it's 110. And guys, the drones are not allowed here. I bought my drone, but the guard stopped us over there. He's not allowing us to carry it any further from the checkpost, so no drone shots. During the peak monsoon, we can only stop till here and enjoy the view from this location. This is the viewpoint, but now since the flow is really less, we're gonna go up close to the waterfall. The stream crossing was kind of difficult. I did not expect that. It is challenging, but it is doable. Enjoy the cinematic.
This is an all-season waterfall, which is formed by several streams flowing in Kalaramane Ghat. The waterfall later joins the backwaters of Kotsali Dam and then flows into the Kali River. If you're coming here, just take a moment and look at the rock formations around. They are so unique, making this waterfall truly a breathtaking splash.
So guys, that was Satodi Waterfall. In the videos, it might look small, but it's really massive. This is a must-visit waterfall in Karnataka. It was kind of difficult to cross the stream, but whatever we saw, it was worth coming here. Right now, we are heading towards another waterfall, that is Magoda Waterfall. It is kind of popular here in Yellapur as well. There, we can't go to the base of the waterfall. We just have to stand at the viewpoint. So we're gonna quickly visit that, and then we're gonna head to Jainu Kallu Gudda. That's an amazing viewpoint here in Yellapur. Let's go. Forgot that we also had to visit that hanging bridge, and it is just 1 kilometer from the diversion. So we'll just have a quick stop here and then we're gonna head to Margot Falls.
The road to Margot Falls is quite similar to what we have experienced while going towards Satodi Falls, which was complete off-road. Once you cross this tough terrain, you'll come across a T-intersection.
This road will take you to Margot Falls and this will lead you towards Kulli Margot Falls. Actually, there are two waterfalls here. The main Margot Falls, which is really huge. We're gonna go next. But right now we're trekking down to the Kulli Waterfalls. I guess this is a very popular spot here because you can see trash. By that, you can assume that many people come here on a daily basis. Now there are two paths and we are confused, but I can hear the stream of the waterfall. One goes from here and one goes from here. I believe this is it because I can see a chips packet. So we're gonna follow this route. Follow the markings, guys. Modern way of marking the trail. I think I've reached because I see a stream flowing right next to me. This must be kind of difficult to hike during monsoon because the trail will be completely covered with water. Wow, this waterfall on the internet looks small, but in reality, it's very tall. So that was Kulli Margot Falls, guys, and right now we have come to the main Margot Falls, which is really huge. I'm not gonna spend much time here because it's just a viewpoint and we also have to reach Jenukallu Gudda for the sunset. So I'm gonna just fly my drone and show you guys Margot Falls from the bird's eye view. Check it out.
Like Satodi, even this is an all-season waterfall where Birti River falls from a height of 200 meters in two tiers, making this one of the highest waterfall in Karnataka. The water looks so clean, it feels like to jump right in. But you can only breathe the waterfall by standing at this viewpoint.
I hope you guys liked the shots. If you did, just please drop down your reviews in the comments below. And also suggest me some new places from your town or village which you want me to come explore and share my stories through such videos. Enough of North. I'm from Karwar and I'm thinking to showcase all the unexplored places nearby which are truly beautiful and uncharted and are away from all the tourist maps. So if you have any such places, drop down in the comments below. So guys, right now we are at Jenukallu Gudda. This is just a viewpoint. You can enjoy the magical sunset over here and there is not much to do. Some people say that there is a trek, but I'm not sure from where we have to start. But from here, the view looks orgasmic. As you can see, it's completely covered with western ghats. It's full greenery. And right now, I guess it's gonna rain as well. So on the top, you can see clouds. And down, you can see the sun rays falling right through the clouds. And down is the beautiful meadows, the western ghats. It looks magical. Check it out. So that's it from Yellapur, guys. I'm gonna end this video here. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, then you know the drill. Like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys on next one. Peace.
Wait. Bonus content. There is another waterfall just 30 kilometers from Yellapur. It's called as Devkar Waterfall. The height of the waterfall, it's 300 feet. It's really massive. But the only downfall is you can't go close to the waterfall, you just have to stay at the top and enjoy the view. But if you have a drone, then you are in for a treat, my friend. Enjoy these bangles.